Okay, good morning. My voice is audible to everyone, right? Confirmation, please. Okay, thank you so much, Mr. Vishal. Thank you. Sharing my screen, and here we are. Okay, so let's go and see what we were there, what we had started with in the last question. So the question was like this. Let me read that again so that we'll be able to get it in a better way, giving you the brief overview of that question again. Mr. Republican, who was the finance manager of US Limited, had given a proposal to give 7% growth rate on dividends to be distributed among shareholders of US Limited forever. So that is a constant growth rate for a perpetual life of the share. The last dividend was 12 rupees. Another proposal was made by Mr. Democrat. Let's see that. However, the shareholders did not fall into rhetoric of Mr. Republican, and they voted out him from the power. This question seems to be very biased against Mr. Republican. How did you come to know whether it was rhetoric or not? But anyway, it's a discriminated question, you know, anyway. They appointed Mr. Democrat as the new finance manager of US Limited. Mr. Democrat has given a new proposal to give shareholders the growth rate of 10% for the next initial 5 years, 7% for the next 5 years, and 4% thereafter forever. The overall expectations of shareholders of US Limited is 14% in terms of cost of equity. You are required to find that which proposal would have fetched more market price as per the dividend growth model. You are also supposed to write your observations. So two proposals were discussed extensively last time. In one, you have a constant growth rate. We had found the value of the shares at a constant growth rate that was somewhere around 183.43. You expect that dividend will grow for the perpetual life at 7%, we applied the formula of the dividend discounting model with the constant growth rate. We got 183.43. But the proposal made by Mr. Democrat was little complex, divided into three phases: 5 years, 10% growth rate. Growth rate of dividend, right? 5 to 10 years, or I may say 6 to 10 years, it will be 7%, and then forever from 11th year onwards, it will be 4%. Now, my friends, see what we are doing in the dividend discounting model is we try to find the present value of all the expected benefits from the share. Now, benefits from a share is nothing but a dividend, right? You try to find the present value for all this number of years. Now, the perpetuity starts from the 11th year onwards. But up to this 10th year, we have got a specific growth rate at which the dividend will grow. So then we can find the present value of all these 10 years. No, putting separately. Then for perpetuity, we'll see later on. Perpetuity will be discussed later on. For 10 years, if something is given to you, then you can find the present value by taking each cash flow of the year separately, right? So what I'm doing is, I am creating one table and starting with the serial number. So serial number, or I may say the year number. How many number of years will be there? 10 years. Then I will say expected dividend. Now we are supposed to find the present value, no? So expected dividend must be discounted by a discounting rate, right? Or it must be multiplied by the discounting factor. Then only you get the present value. So I will treat all of these cash inflows in terms of dividend separately, and we will find the present value of each of these 10 years dividend. Then we have got discounting factor. And then we'll be able to get PV, right? Now you'll keep more space for this expected dividend because some mathematical calculations will happen there. Let's write it for first 5 years. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Last year's dividend was how much? 12 rupees. Now for the first 5 years, it is supposed to grow at what percentage? 10%. Just a second. Started working. So on 12 rupees, if you pay 10% growth rate, then you can multiply the 12 by 1.10. So you get the expected dividend of the next year, right? So whenever you are supposed to find a future value or the future price of anything and the growth rate is given to you, what do? You multiply that with a compounding factor. So compounding factor is nothing but 1 plus r raised to n, right? That was a compounding factor, if you can recall it. So that was multiplied with the present value. So you were getting the future value. Now here in this case, instead of future value, what do I have? The expected dividend from a share. A 10% increment in 12 rupees. And then whatever the expected dividend I'll get, no, that dividends will further be discounted. Because right now I want to reach to a present value, no, to value the shares. So 12 multiplied by 1.10. You can write it for second one. 12 multiplied by 1.10 raised to 2. So n will become 2, no, for 2 years. I hope you are getting my point. 10% is added for 2 years. 10% for 1 year, 10% for 2 years. So we'll get the expected value after some time. Then in 12 rupees, you will add 10% for 3 years. So 1.10 raised to 3. Then for the fourth year, you will raise 10% in 12 for 4 years, right? So 12 multiplied by 1.10 raised to 4. Then 12 multiplied by 1.10 raised to 5. Now, if you are unable to get it, it's very simple to understand. Calculator lo, 12 rupe likho, usme 10% add karo. So you will get some money. Now in that dividend, again, there will be 10%. So again, add 10% in the value you have got in the calculator. So you will get for second year. Again, in the previous amount, you get 10%. You get third year. So whatever the value you get for all these years, no, keep on adding 10% in your calculator. That is also very easy way to do this. But from the sixth year onwards, thing changed. So 12 multiplied by 1.10 raised to 5, because for 6 years, 5 years growth rate will be added at 10%. And for the sixth year too, there will be a growth rate of 7%. So it will be 1.07, 7% only. No, let me just check it. Yes. So 5 years with 10% and 1 year with 7% on 12 rupees. For seventh year, I can write it like 12 multiplied by 1.10 raised to 5 and then 1.07 raised to 2. 10% for 5 years, 7% for 2 years. सातवें साल के एंड में मैं क्या डिविडेंड एक्सपेक्ट करता हूं? What is the expected dividend at the end of the seventh year? What should I do? I would add 10% for 5 years and 7% for 2 years. That can mathematically be expressed like this. For 8, 9 and 10. So 12 multiplied by 1.10 raised to 5 multiplied by 1.07 raised to 3. 12 multiplied by 1.10 raised to 5 multiplied by 1.07 raised to 4. 12 multiplied by 1.010 raised to 5 multiplied by 1.07 raised to 5. I hope everyone is able to get this. और अगर नहीं समझ में आया तो बहुत इजी है, तो हमारे पास शॉर्टकट तो है ही बेटा. 12 रुपए में तुम 10% ऐड करो, कितना आता है कौन बताएगा? 1.2 इफ यू ऐड इन 12 रुपीस, 13.2 विल बी देयर, राइट? लेट मी राइट दैट विद अ डिफरेंट कलर. इन दैट यू अगेन ऐड 10%. व्हाट डू यू गेट? कैन समवन टेल मी प्लीज? What do you get if you add 10? I couldn't get your voice, sorry. Couldn't get your voice, please.
So 14.52.
52, very good. In that, again you add 10%.
15.972.
15.972, very good. In that, again 10%.
17.569.
Very good. Next one.
19.326.
Friends, now you will not add 10%. You will add 7% on 19.326. So on 19.326, if you add 7%, what do you get? Please.
20.679.
उसके बाद भी 7%?
22.126.
Very good. Next one.
23.675.
Amazing. Next one.
25.333.
And the last one.
27.106.
Others may cross verify this dividends, please. May I have a confirmation from the chat box that others have got it? Har ek ke same answer aa rahe, wo thoda sa cross verify kar lo beta. Now once you get the expected dividend for all these years after adding your growth rate, you know, you will have to find the present value, because ultimate purpose in this question is to reach to a present value of all the benefits we receive from a share. Now discount factor will be, which is the expected rate of return of shareholders. That is how one divided by 1.14. So you will keep on getting the discounting factor for all these years. So you will get the present value. What do we get for the first year? Can someone tell me, please? 1 divided by 1.14. And try to understand it very conceptually, friends. Why I'm discounting it 14%? Because K is what we take as the required rate of return. Yes, please. The first one. 1 divided by 1.14.
0.8772.
8772. Very nice. Next one.
0.7695.
Okay, next one.
0.6750.
Very nice. Next one.
0.5921.
Okay, next one.
0.5193.
Amazing. Next one.
0.4556.
Okay, next one.
0.3996.
Okay, next one.
0.3506.
Very good. Next.
0.3075.
And the last one.
0.2697.
ओके थैंक यू सो मच सर. कितना काम करवाते हो, ऐसे क्वेश्चन क्यों फ्रेम करते हो कि इतना टाइम लगता है? बेटा लर्निंग में कोई कॉम्प्रोमाइज नहीं, अपन पूछे ना पूछे वो बात की बात है. ओके वी गेट द प्रेजेंट वैल्यू नाउ राइट. यू मल्टीप्लाई द डिस्काउंटिंग फैक्टर विद द एक्सपेक्टेड डिविडेंड. एक्सपेक्टेड डिविडेंड इज बेसिकली अ फ्यूचर वैल्यू यू हैव गॉट. सो मल्टीप्लाई दैट एक्सपेक्टेड डिविडेंड with a discounting factor, you get the present value. So you will get the present value for all these 10 years. What to do with the 11th year onwards? That we'll discuss later on. Just forget that. Let's do it for 10 years. First one, what do we get? Discounting factor multiplied by expected dividend. This one you will be taking 13.2 multiplied by 0.8772.
11.5790.
11.5790. Next one.
11.173.
11.1731. So we are going for 4 digits. Yes, very true. Okay, next one.
10.7811.
Okay, next one.
10.4026.
Okay, next one.
11.4274.
Okay, next one.
11.2618.
Okay, next one.
8.8415.
Okay, very good. Next one.
8.3004.
Okay, second last.
7.7899.
Just a second. 7.78.
Double nine.
Okay, and the last one.
7.3104.
Very good. So if you do the total of this PV, you will be able to know what will be the present value of expected dividend for upcoming 10 years, right? सो एटलीस्ट हमें 10 साल का तो डिस्काउंटेड वैल्यू मिल गया शेयर का, फिर उसके बाद की बात बाद में करते हैं. सो लेट्स फाइंड द प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ 10 इयर्स, पीवी ऑफ डिविडेंड ऑफ 10 इयर्स. सो इक्वल्स टू डू द टोटल ऑफ ऑल द पीवीज. सो प्लीज पुट द आंसर ओवर देयर. Do it and let me know. अच्छा भैया आंसर आ जाए तो बता दीजिए.
87.8014
87.8014. अदर्स में क्रॉस वेरीफाई दिस प्लीज. एक दो डेसिमल में फर्क हो तो कोई बात नहीं, उसमें चलता है, लेकिन 2-5 रुपए का फर्क आता है तो बता रहा. ओके. लेकिन सर हमारी अधूरी कहानी, बिकॉज फ्रॉम 11th ईयर ऑनवर्ड्स वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू यू नो गो आई मीन फॉरगेट अवर डिविडेंड्स. वी हैव द कॉन्स्टेंट ग्रोथ रेट एक्सपेक्टेशन फ्रॉम द 11th ईयर ऑनवर्ड्स एज पर द प्रपोजल मेड बाई मिस्टर डेमोक्रेट. सो फ्रॉम हियर वी कैन अप्लाई द फॉर्मूला ऑफ द कॉन्स्टेंट ग्रोथ रेट दैट वी यूज टू अप्लाई इन द लास्ट क्वेश्चन. सो इफ यू कैन रिकॉल इट, द फॉर्मूला वॉज लाइक प्राइज ऑफ शेयर, आई मीन द प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ ऑल द फ्यूचर कैश इनफ्लोस इक्वल्स टू डी जीरो इन ब्रेकेट 1+G डिवाइडेड बाई के माइनस जी. सो पी जीरो इज नथिंग बट द प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ ऑल फ्यूचर इनफ्लोस, राइट? नाउ माई फ्रेंड यू विल गेट अ प्रेजेंट वैल्यू at 11th year, because after 10 years you are there into an 11th year, right? You are at the beginning of the 11th year, and now you want to see that what will be the present value of all the cash inflows for upcoming perpetuity, upcoming unforeseeable future. So you will be taking the last dividend. D0 stands basically for the last dividend. So the formula will be like dividend of 10th year multiplied by 1+G divided by KE minus G. That will be the present value of this share at the 11th year. I hope you are getting my point. Or I may say at the beginning of the 11th year. 10 years discounted value we have found, but we are supposed to find the present value at the 11th year as well. No, now. So what is the dividend of the 10th year? Dividend of the 10th year will be this 27.106. Do not take the present value. Here is where the people make the mistake. One fellow had calculated this entire sum very perfectly, but he took the present value 7.3104. No. You had received the dividend of 27.106 in the 10th year. 7.3104 is the present value as of today. So here we are taking the dividend of the 10th year, the actually distributed dividend, which will be 27.106 multiplied by 1+G. Now forever, what is the growth rate expectations you have? 4%, right? So I am writing 0.04. KE will be again remaining the same at 0.14. Let me just check it. 14 minus 0.04 growth rate expectations. So equals to 27.106. I am doing the star mark over here, because here is where people makes the mistake. They take the present value. Do not take the present value of the 10th year. Take the actually distributed dividend of the 10th year, which is 27.106, multiplied by 1.04 to be divided by 0.10. So what do we get in a numerator? Can someone tell me, please?
28.1902.
That is to be divided by 0.10. So what do we get? I guess 281.902, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Again, mark my words very carefully. This is the present value at the 11th year. लेकिन हम तो अभी इधर है, प्रेजेंट में है. ये जो 11th ईयर के बिगिनिंग से पहले भी हमारे 10 साल हो चुके हैं. सो 281.902 विल बी द वैल्यू ऑफ द शेयर एट 11th ईयर. आई एम देयर राइट नाउ इन द प्रेजेंट. आई वांट टू फाइंड द प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ ऑल द कैश इनफ्लोज एंड बेनिफिट्स टुडे. So this will further be converted into a present value. So present value of share price at 11th year will be 281.902 multiplied by the discounting factor of the 10th year. We are there into beginning of the 11th year. So that's basically the end of the 10th year. So end of the 10th year's discounting factor can also be taken, which is 0.2697. So you multiply that with 0.2697, you get the present value of the share price of 11th year. So can someone tell me what do you get there? I'm putting the star mark. Here is where the people gets stuck. Yes, please. What do you get? 281.902?
76.029.
Very good. Now that's the present value of the share at 11th year. Now in total, you have received two benefits. Up to 10 year, the present value of all cash inflows, PV of cash inflows, and after 10th year, that means 11th year onwards, PV of cash inflows. So up to 10 year, what was the total? That table we had prepared, no? 87.8014. Yes, please.
So instead of 87, it is 95.6351.
It is 90.
Totaling. Okay.
95.6351. Okay. Sir, I'm getting 98.8673.
Oh my God. Many people are getting the different answers here.
Sir, I am getting 95.6351.
Okay. Let me check what is the answer of others there. Urja? Harsh? Dekho, calculate karo kya aate hai. मेरे पास तो एक्सेल हेच धोखा हो गया. बच्चों ने मेरे साथ धोखा कर दिया. मैं बोला बच्चे मेरे को अच्छे आंसर देंगे, सच्चे आंसर देंगे. एनीवे, आई विल डू इट. डोंट, नथिंग टू बी वरीड अबाउट. एक ही मिनट का काम है, कुछ ज्यादा टाइम नहीं लगता इसमें. हम पीपल लाइक सर, एक ही मिनट का काम है तो पूरा लेक्चर क्यों लेते हो? क्या करें बेटा, जरूरत पड़ती है, लेने पड़ते हैं. Okay, so discounting factor should get 14% each. So equals to 1 divided by 1.14 raised to 1. We get the discounting factors. Now we'll have to just multiply this with the discounting factor. We get the PVs. Let me do the total of this. Then the PV will be 95.6369. So all the people who are getting somewhere near to 95.6, all of them will be considered right. So 95.6369. Others would have made some mistake. Please cross verify that. 95.6369. Anyway, let's go to the question. Try to understand it conceptually, what I'm doing. Then we had found the value of the share at 11th year. A value of the share at 11th year can be found by taking the dividend of the 10th year. And then we may apply the constant growth rate formula there. So we get the value at the 11th year, 281.902, but that is the value at the 11th year, should be converted at present. Abhi mein aana hai, abhi ke liye find karna. So discounting factor of 10th year will be multiplied with that value. So you get 76.029. So two benefits you get. Up to 10 year, you have the present value of cash inflows. And after 11th year onwards, you have the present value of cash inflows. So up to 10 year, the total is 95.6369. And 11th year onwards, you have the total of 76.029. If you do the total of this, it will be a present value of all the cash inflows expected from a share. So PV of all dividend from shares equals to PV of 10 years plus PV of market price of 11th year. So equals to, again I'm writing 95.6369 plus 76.029. Can someone give me a total, please? What do we get there?
171.6659.
That is the present value of your share. Now, my friend, try to understand. There were two proposals made, right? One proposal was made by Mr. Republican. And according to the proposal made by Mr. Republican, the market value of a share was coming at 183.43. Let me highlight that in a different color. 183.43. And as for the proposal made by Mr. Democrat, the value of the share of US Limited is coming at 171.66. So you tell me, which proposal is fetching the higher value? Democrat or Republican? Your comments, please. Which proposal is fetching the higher value? Very true, Mr. Vishal. Republican. Very true. तो वो सिंपल वाला ग्रोथ रेट है ना भैया, वो अच्छा था. समझ रहे हो मेरी बात? तो अगर मेरे को कोई पूछे, if someone asks me like this, that in which proposal the value of the share will be highest? If you expect the 7% growth rate forever from now onwards, or you expect 10% for initial 5 years, 10% for next 5 years, 7% for next 5 years, and 4% thereafter. I would go with 7% forever because that fetches the highest value. I hope that is clear to everyone. That may be written as the observation in your notes. that as per the proposal made by Mr. Republican, the value is this much. As per the proposal made by Mr. Democrat, the value is this much. So as a company, if we want to maximize the value, we should go with 7% growth rate on dividend. At that proposal, the value will be highest. I hope that is clear to everyone. May I have a confirmation from the students through the chat box that till now, whatever the things we have discussed, you are crystal clear about that? Confirmation through the chat box, please. Received it from Mr. Mohit, Mr. Neev, Mr. Hardik, Ms. Priska, very nice. Others, I'm assuming that you people are getting it. क्योंकि सर अंतर या में बिल्कुल नहीं है, कुछ भी अगर नहीं समझ में आ रहा है तो बताना पड़ेगा आपको बेटा. गुजराती में कहवत है ना कि माइगा वगर तो माए ना फिर से, तो बेटा मैं तो इंसान हूँ. मिस्टर विशाल इज सेइंग सर रिपीट फ्रॉम द 11th ईयर प्राइस, वेरी गुड, आई लाइक इट. बताओ बेटा, कुछ नहीं समझ में आ रहा है तो बताओ. अपने को बिल्कुल ऐसे दिखाना नहीं है कि नहीं समझ में आता. मेरे को तो बहुत मेहनत करने के बाद ये समझ में आया था. मैं अपनी खुद की बात बताऊं तो ओके सर, सी अप टू 10 इयर्स यू हैव गॉट द प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ डिविडेंड, राइट? नाउ यू विल एक्सपेक्ट 4% फॉर एवर फ्रॉम 11th ईयर ऑनवर्ड्स. So you can find the market value, or I may say the value of the share as per Mr. Gordon at the 11th year by applying a growth rate. So at 11th year, what do you get? So you will be taking the last dividend as the 10th year's dividend, and you will apply the growth rate formula 1 plus G divided by K minus G. So sir, you got the value of 281.902, but that is the value at 11th year. All the cash inflows after 11th year are discounted at 11th year, and we have got the value at 11th year, at the beginning of the 11th year, which is 281.902. But we are not at the 11th year, we are there into right now, present. So that 11th year's value should also be converted into a present value of the 0 year today. So that will be multiplied with 0.2697, because that is the discounting factor of the 10th year. We are at the beginning of the 11th, that is also the end of the 10th year, right? So you get the present value of the value of 11th year. Get my point? You get the present value, which is 76.2029. That is the present value of the value of 11th year. So you add that 76.29029, and up to 10 years you have anyway got the value, which is 95.6369. So you total this out, this will be the total cash inflows in terms of dividend expected from a company. So that reaches out to 171.6659. Now you can imagine how complicated it will be to value the businesses, because businesses will anyway having a perpetual life. We assume that it will remain survive for n number of periods, and accordingly we'll have to value the business based on their discounting. This has been asked while you raise the finance for your startups and cap for your new ventures. When you seek a project finance from any investor, no, they tell you that what is the valuation of your business. Here we have taken the shares valuation, but the same thing, same fundamentals, everything will apply to the business valuation too. In that, you will take the cash inflows of the entire business for all the years. I hope everyone is getting my point. Is it clear, Mr. Vishal, now? Very good. Thank you so much. Well, so that's it from my side. As far as the Gordon's model is concerned, only model which is pending to be discussed is the Modigliani-Miller model. नहीं, वन मोर इज देयर आफ्टर दैट, आई एम सॉरी, लिंटर्स मॉडल इज आल्सो देयर. सो देयर आर टू मॉडल्स टू बी डिस्कस्ड टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ शेयर बाय यूजिंग द डिविडेंड कॉन्सेप्ट. So that's it from my side for the day. Please put your enrollment number as a marker for attendance. See you all again in the next session with utmost of energy and enthusiasm. Please take care of yourself. Please put the enrollment number.